This is Good Morning San Diego.
Well, parents for quality education are pushing back against mask policies in schools.
After the break, we are catching up with the president of the group, Mark Powell. He is going to be on the show to talk about what's being done to have those policies reversed and why. Why he feels so strongly about it. That's ahead as Good Morning San Diego returns.
Okay, let's go back. I had just mentioned that based on what we know at this point in time, it seems illogical to make kids wear masks in school. You can pick it up from there.
No, because it sends a bad message. What it sends is that schools are not as safe as other places. So kids now are vaccinated for a lot of different things. They have chickenpox, diphtheria, mumps, measles, rubella. They don't have to wear masks because of these vaccinations. So why should they have to wear masks if they're vaccinated for COVID-19? It doesn't make any sense. Then the vaccination is 95% effective. So they shouldn't have to wear masks if they're vaccinated.
And talk about this from a mental health standpoint. Kids walking around with their faces covered all day. I guess they're allowing them a few minutes to have mask breaks or something like that.
Well, they can have a mask break, but it's the messaging that I was trying to mention earlier, and I don't know if the audience heard that. When you tell kids that it's safe to go everywhere else in San Diego, you can go to the mall, you can go to parties, you can go to these little restaurants that have game centers in them, yet when you go to school, you have to wear a mask. Why are schools not as safe as the other places that you're going to? It doesn't make any sense. And for a younger child, it could be very damaging to them thinking that, hey, my school is not safe.
Well, we know that they are the least vulnerable. They're not spreaders by and large. What is the real motivation behind this, in your opinion?
Well, I can tell you, backers for this are teachers unions, the American Federation of Teachers, the National Association of Teachers, or NEA, National Educators Association, are recommending masks until the end of the year. Although the CDC is recommending face coverings, yet none of them are mandating them. 27 states do not have mandates for schools to wear face coverings. So it's very confusing as to why California is one of those states that's mandating face covering, especially when we're doing so well and they're bragging about how high our vaccination rates are.
Well, 27 states, and if you add them all up, as far as I understand, none of those schools have had any types of even close to outbreaks.
No, and you know what the sad thing is, Jason, is that schools aren't really teaching kids about preventive measures. They typically scare the kids and tell them you have to wear a mask, you don't want to get them, wash your hands, do this, but they don't emphasize enough. You need to exercise. You need to take vitamins if you have to. You need to eat healthy. You need to make sure that your weight's in line. Get out there and get outside and get enough sunlight. These are the things that help kids become more resistant to getting infections. Not scaring them into a corner saying, wear a mask, be afraid, you're going to get these things.
Well, you mentioned the teachers unions just a moment ago, but as far as I know, weren't teachers some of the first to be vaccinated?
Well, yes, and I know teachers. And I was a teacher. I talk to teachers all the time. You know what they tell me? I don't want to wear a mask. I'm vaccinated. I got vaccinated, so I don't have to wear a mask. Yet they're still mandated to wear a mask. But you know, all other agencies, well, not all other agencies, but restaurants and stores, if you can prove that you're vaccinated, you don't have to wear a mask. That came out from Jerry Sanders. So why should they have to wear a mask? Why are they mandated to wear a mask? They should also have the choice to wear a mask or not.
And who specifically hands down this mandate?
Well, the governor is the one who put this mandate in place. But you see, we have 42 school districts in San Diego County. There is very little pushback from the school districts or the 215 elected school board representatives that are out there right now. So the position that we're taking is, if you're vaccinated, you should not have to wear a mask. If you're in school and a parent wants you to wear a mask, whether you're vaccinated or not, you should wear a mask. It should be a parental choice. Let parents decide what to do for their children.
And what do you recommend for any parents who are out there who are totally on your side? They're saying, I'm tired of my kid having to wear a mask at school. It's ridiculous. It defies logic. What actions can they take to make sure their voices are heard?
Well, the biggest action they can make is at the ballot box. because you have to find out where your elected school board member stands on this. And you need to ask them, where do you stand personally on wearing masks? Do you support wearing masks in school, or do you not support wearing masks in school? And based upon that, it's going to help you make a decision on whether or not you want to vote these people in or vote them out. And also contact the governor. Let the governor know you do not want your child to wear a mask because your child got vaccinated. Both my kids got vaccinated, and the Pfizer vaccination is 95% effective against COVID-19 after the second dose. So why are they wearing masks if they're 95% effective and they don't have to wear them anywhere else? This is common sense, just very common sense.
And as they say, common sense ain't so common.
Isn't so common. Right? That's right. And so, it ain't okay. So common. Yeah.
Okay, Mark. And just in closing, I just want to make sure we're clear on this. Governor Gavin Newsom could end this today with the stroke of a pen.
He, just like all of a sudden on June 15th, you couldn't get coronavirus if you're walking through a restaurant. By that quickly? Yeah, absolutely he could do it, you know? I don't know why he's not, but... He could do it.
Okay, Mark Powell, website presence where folks can go to find out more?
Yeah, parentsforqualityeducation.org.
Parentsforqualityeducation.org. Okay.
That's Mark correct. Powell. Thanks, Jason.
Hey, great talking to you, Mark.
Thank you, sir.